everyone. Recently, I announced a bunch of new shows that I'm calling an electronic live set. And a lot of people were understandably confused by that. So I figured I'd offer a bit of an explanation and sort of just show you what I'm actually doing. Maybe to put it in context, I could explain what different types of performances I've done in the past. So I actually got my start in about 2010 doing essentially DJing. I was actually using Ableton at the time, but it was always kind of track based. It was very kind of standard DJing. Got to fly all over the world and play all kinds of interesting shows. And after I started to work on Strangers, the first record in 2014, I realized that the music that I was writing was more conducive to a band. So that's when I got a band together. I got a bunch of my friends, the whole thing together. It was kind of a big production, and it was a lot of fun. I mean, we toured for many years, and I think it got to a point where I was really interested in playing a different type of set, I guess, and in the kind of material that I was writing, especially more recently, was more conducive to that. So I figured I would change things up a bit. So I'm still basically building this off of like the DJ concept. So I have, two decks, like a deck one and a deck two. I could have a full track running, or I could have multiple stems from each track running. I could have just loops running. I could do whatever I want. And then I have a sort of a drum section, which is all just drum loops that I handpicked for each individual song. I also have a live section, which has a lot of virtual instruments, things like that. And all of these things combined allow me to perform in a more kind of nuanced and direct way. Often with DJing, you're sort of working with like a finished track. It's not really malleable. I mean, you can edit it and you can do a lot of that pre-production type of work. But I felt like we were at a point with technology that we could do all of this stuff on the fly. And I started a couple years ago, I started to build out this system. And this is sort of the latest version of it. I would say that this is always going to be a work in progress. That's just the very nature of it. But the whole idea is that I would take almost 12 years worth of music, organize them by parts. So, drums, bass, synths, pianos, whatever, vocals, organize them by type, organize them by BPM, and organize them by key. And then I can just mix and match and pick different things and essentially, create new music on the fly as a sort of a derivative work of everything else that I've already done. So it's a bit of a daunting task, but one that I'm very excited about and also very excited about to do with an audience. Anyway, I'm just going to stop talking now and just get into this and show you what's going on. If I trigger one of the many intro scenes that I have, for example, this one, deck two is running a variety of different loops. So I'm going to start to bring those up. Well, first I have to bring up the master channel, then I'm going to bring up the individual things. And the way I know that these tracks are playing is because it takes a little bit of practice and you kind of develop a memory for like where each of these loops are running from. So this is a mix of, I think, a CRO sample and some horns that I have for my Edward Sharpe remix. So then I can start to mix in like a couple of vocal chops, things like that. So now that I'm going to mix in another track, or another group of loops, I am going to pull up deck one and go over here to the second scene and start to bring that in. Now there's a variety of different live elements that are running too. Some of them are virtual synths, some of them are hardware synths. So, I'm running this synth right now. There's actually two synths, but combined together. Here, if I filter out the samples, let me show you what's going on here. And I can also add effects to these, for example. It's more for, you know, added effect or just kind of transition options. So I like to just have this kind of running for a bit, set the mood, set the tone. And then I can finally go over here and actually trigger the song to start. I'm gonna start to bring up some drums. There's nothing playing right now, but I just wanna have it ready. Can quickly get too chaotic, so it's something that kind of need to always be looking at. So I'm gonna drop in some drums here in this part right here. Something a little punchier. So I have to bring down those vocal samples a little bit. And instead of faders, I actually have filters on these, so I can kind of bring it out. And now bring in the bass. How I can bring out the drums here. The idea is to make it just playable as opposed to just a fader. I'm gonna start bringing that synth in again. I really like to filter out stuff, so it's a great way to kind of play with this. I'm starting to mix in some samples from my Porter Robinson remix. So this, you know, these loops are going, they're kind of like a transition. Start to bring out those drums a little bit. Now I can actually go into the full Porter Robinson track. Thank you. So as you can see, I can start to layer, you know, multiple different loops and different things together in real time. It's sort of like creative, sort of like rearranging the song on the fly. It offers many, many flexibilities. It just makes the show more fun for me, honestly, as opposed to just playing the track regularly. So I have this hook from the Odessa track that I remixed, and I'm just gonna start to bring in some of that stuff. So as you can see, like, these drums aren't in the original, obviously, but I can filter them down, start to create these builds as well. This is a beat repeat, so kind of corny, but it works. So I have these, I have these vocal samples. Try to bring those in. Down a bit. Back to the verse, I'm gonna bring those loops out. Actual hook in. That one guitar part kind of clashes sometimes, so I always have to remember to bring it down a bit. Okay, so at this point, I'm just gonna skip ahead and kind of start to fade out the original Odessa, or the original Porter Robinson track. So I have these loops going with the Odessa sample, which I like. So now we're just gonna bring in the full track there. Strings can get kind of overbearing sometimes, so just bring those out. And I just switch the bass there. And I could do this at any point, you know, I just happen to do it when the verse comes in. I could wait for the chorus, I could do all kinds of different things. It's fun to kind of jam on this. If I just wanted the vocal too, I could just leave that. Filter out the loop, and then, you know, bring it back. What I love about this is that you can do this dynamically at any point. You don't have to edit the song beforehand. You can just kind of jam. And I think that's what I really like about it. Of course, this vocal part clashes a bit. But, you know, that's the part that I really like about it. It's live, you know? Just skipping ahead here, I'm gonna kind of like crudely transition here. So in a way, it's kind of like DJing with like 32 CDJs. It's kind of a lot, and it can get overwhelming. But you know, if you take your time and do things slowly, you can really create something interesting. At this point, playing a loop of a song I did with Rostam. I'm just gonna kind of crudely skip around here just so you can kind of see some of the options that I have. So this is like a drum breakdown. So you know, I have some melodies happening here. But it's kind of fun. You can do kind of like some breakbeaty stuff. Recording and audio at the same time, but we'll make it through. So I have this loop going for Cheap Sunglasses, and Cheap Sunglasses is fun because it's a major key song. And it works a lot of other stuff, so this is just a loop, and I'm gonna trigger some different samples here, bring out the drums a bit. The vocal sample keeps going, and I have these guitar. Yeah, what song I got? I got it from a well-known classical guitar piece. Just kind of chopped it up. So right now, I just want to keep that vocal loop going, right? And there's no drums here, so I'm gonna kind of move on to the next section. guitar. You know, just a couple different loops from different bits, different parts of the song that I kind of looped into rhythm and create something different. Now let's try to bring some of the synth elements here. Bass is starting to come in. Out of it. About this type of set is that you can, I can essentially write music specifically for it. So it's less about playing my own tracks or whatever. It's like literally I can just create my own music on the fly. So we go back to that Debussy sample. Just jamming on this thing. So. So I'm going to start to bring in a variety of different vocal chops that I have.